zoom in?
I'm as zoomed as I can. You don't want me to take too much of this, do you?
No, no, save it for the game because we don't have the battery to run out.
And welcome to Titan Field for the 1996 Southern Section CIF ARCO AM/PM Baseball Championship game. This evening's Division III final features the La Mirada High School Matadors. High School Chargers. The visiting team, La Mirada, champion of the Suburban League, enters tonight's contest with a season record of 22-7. The Matadors have advanced to the championship game with playoff wins over Harupa, Antelope Valley, La Quinta, and Altaloma. Charter Oak, runner-up in the Miramonte League, enters the contest with a record of 21-8. The Chargers have advanced to the finals with playoff wins. Open for tonight's game. First, the visiting La Mirada Matadors. Number one, David Ortega. Ryan Treat. Number six, Brandon Haskins. Number nine, Tim Lemon. Number 15, Devin Maskey. Number 17, Jesse Tate. Number 28, Ryan Odom. Shortstop, number five, Jack Brooks. Batting second, playing left field, number 11, Ken Harrington. Tonight's pitcher, number 22, Ben Orr. Catching, batting fourth, number 10, Tim Halleck. Batting in the fifth position, playing third base, number 8, Jeff Nicolini. Batting 6, first baseman, number 21, Josh Barton. Batting 7, second baseman, number 7, Rob Castro. Center fielder, batting 8, number 20, Greg Rudiger. Batting 9, right fielder, Jim Zern. The La Mirada Matadors, head coach Kim Brooks. And now, the home team, the Charter Oak Chargers.
Thank you. better get far away up close. Tell me where it goes. Get the camera on Ben or on the batter or both. Well, so much for a no hitter.
Huh?
So much for a no hitter.
Oh, there's not going to be a no hitter in this game.
I don't want to.
Come on, Jimmy!
Is there one? Double play takes him out of the inning.
I was late coming up with my new stuff.
Stephanie.
Now batting, shortstop, number 18, Matt Dizama.
It won't be for too long.
You're sitting down.
Oh, hi.
Hi.
I'm looking over your head. You're here again.
I know. You know, I asked Karen again if she was coming. She's like, oh, yeah. I know.
Yeah.
She's like,
oh,
very, very bad, but what do you do?
Oh, well, there's always another day coming.
I know. That was
nice. That was
number 19, John Padilla.
Thank you.
Now batting, first baseman, number 31, Dave Keppel. Now batting, catching, number 13, John Alexander.
Then. Oh, yeah.
now batting, second baseman, number 12, Matt Venegas.
Fifth man.
Ooh, looks like he's starting to bring that right.
What a nice grandpa.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
It was like...
fielder, number 26, Adam Gronkowski.
2 games ago. We had 97 2 games ago.
Yeah.
19, John Alexander.
Yeah.
four innings of play.
Thank you. Thank you.
I think knuckled is the word.
I just think
Larry
is better.
Larry is sick.
What they doing? So,
20, Greg Rudiger.
Thank you.
They're in agreement. No strike one. Diego.
Stop, Ben.
teams lined up. Ladies and gentlemen, we direct your attention to our home player for the presentation of award by Mr. Bill Clark, CIF Assistant Commissioner, and Mr. Dean Crowley, the CIF Southern Section Commissioner. First, your runner-up, Charter Oak Chargers. Championship plaque to head coach Kim Brooks.
He's getting interviewed.
I have to cut out the paper tomorrow.
I'm going to miss seeing you. I never see you.
Hey, piano lessons until the age of 7 develops the left-hand coordination.
Exactly. Tim had him too.
Did you see that article?
5 years old.
Right. Yeah. I heard you graduated.
The brain that controls the left.
Are you almost graduated?
No, December.
I just got that on America Online.
You finished in December?
Ah.
Yeah. Someone said you just graduated now.
Oh, yeah.
I could have walked last week.
Where did you graduate?
From
here?
Strong-headed Christians.
don't know what they want out of life.
I think it's a wise thing too. Go to school first.
Well, he's not really excited when he registered because he discovered this major that's in studio art.
Mm-hmm. He was telling Ellen.
Yeah, so perfect for him.
She said she thought they had two classes together. She thought that was kind of neat.
Yeah, that's what you said. Did you say? Tell me where it goes, because I can never follow the ball in here. Looks like there's going to be a pitcher's game, huh?
Uh-huh.
His classes, huh? Hasn't been in batting cage all week.
Is he on the pitcher's shirt? Where's he from?
Warren? Is it Warren High School?
Oh, Warren. Mm-hmm. Does it sound like Tom's first time? I forget exactly what she said. Yeah, or something, you know.
You can't lie out their name.
But I thought you said maybe you could.
She doesn't think so now. She said after the meeting yesterday.
Very good.
Shop at the outlets.
Greg.
You got me.
City Hall to background information on this presentation. The La Mirada High School varsity baseball team won the Division III CIF Championship with an 8-1 victory over Charter Oak at Cal State Fullerton University. The team posted an overall record of 23-7, which was the best win-loss record in the school's history. And the team also won the Suburban League title with a 13-2 record, which was also the best win-loss record for a league championship by a La Mirada High School baseball team. On their way to the CIF crown, the Matadors posted victories over Arupa Valley, Antelope Valley, La Quinta, Alta Loma, and as I said earlier, the championship game over Charter Oak. This was truly a team victory with everyone contributing to achieve the championship. And those of you that subscribe to the Whittier Daily News, this morning's edition, if you saw it, they mentioned that the area that the San Gabriel Valley newspapers cover, including the Whittier Daily News, announced that Kim Brooks, the coach of the La Mirada High School varsity baseball team, was selected the coach of the year in the San Gabriel Valley area. It is therefore the La Mirada City Council would like to make the following presentations. We have a city plaque with a gold emblem, and Howard and Kim, you'll have to fight over this, but I'm going to call forward Howard Haas, the principal of La Mirada High School, and Kim Brooks, coach of the baseball team, to accept this plaque. This is presented to the La Mirada High School varsity baseball team. So, Kim, I think you're here. 1996 Division III CIF champions. In appreciation for your hard work and dedication in the field of sports, and it has all the names of the La Mirada City Council presented this day, June 11th. Kim, congratulations again.
They don't have to.
They need to go by position.
Mr. Mayor, Councilman, the La Mirada Varsity baseball team would like to thank you for inviting us down here to help with the celebration. It's an exciting time for the kids in the school. And like I've always told the teams that I've coached at La Mirada, it's not just the high school we represent, we represent the whole city. There's only one high school in this town, and it's us. And it adds a little pressure, but it also makes things very sweet and brings us home like this for the city and the school. And we appreciate this little extra effort. This is what makes La Mirada special. You can decide to honor us. Thank you very much. First player, Josh Barton. Brandon Haskins. Ben Orr, who has also just been given the award of the most valuable player in CIF this year. My able assistant and our great pitching coach, Al Smilowitz.
Mr. Mayor, City Council, Gary Sloan, members of the board, members of the school board, members of the community. We had a victory tour last Friday, and we touched, I'd say, at least 5,000 children who are our children at La Mirada, from kindergartners to eighth graders. And the message that we put out was that CIF championships are important, but they're not as important as finding a winning spirit amongst all of us. We went around and we told every single child that they would not be successful. We were talking to 4 and 5 and 6 year olds and kids older. They won't be successful if they get into drugs and if they get into alcohol and they start hanging out with gangs. And these young men were and are incredible role models. And once again, I know I'm sounding like a broken record. There are, I don't know of any other cities anywhere, and also a school board, that would sponsor something like a victory tour. Something that used to probably happen in the old days, maybe before we had buses. But that actually we were able to touch every single child of La Mirada, and these little kids were looking up at heroes of these guys. We brought around kids who had the highest grade point average. We made them heroes. And I think that's the major message we can give all of our kids in La Mirada, that the heroes are every day those people who do great things. We were fortunate and blessed that we got this championship. We're so proud of all the guys and of the middle schools that feed into us. And we're very happy, Mr. Mayor, to give you a signed, autographed CIF baseball that we've already been offered about $200 tonight for. Dave Garcia, we're going to get it for free. In addition, we're going to give you our hat, and hopefully you'll place it in the outside area. But once again, at the bottom of our heart, we thank the community, we thank the school board, we thank the city council. There aren't many places like La Mirada, and gentlemen, my greatest respects and to the coaches, so thank you.
Bring it in on the close-up, yeah. They'll probably give us one. First. No.
Better hurry. Hold on.
Here, hurry.
What? Oh.
No, it's good. It's okay, I got on video.
Strong defensively up the middle because of the plays like that that Marty Rodriguez just showed us.
Nice play by Marty Rodriguez.
Marty will be coming over to Cerritos in the fall, so I know, again, Ken Gaylord's looking forward to having him in the infield.
Here's George Pena from Paramount. First pitch outside. Again, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to thank our sponsors, Muthart Chrysler Plymouth of Cerritos, Action Shirts, and Yuri Photo for making all this possible. There's a ground ball to first. Unassisted. Two away quickly in the ninth. Sorensen takes that one himself. Here comes Ariel Gitron. Gitron's got to get on here if the National wants to keep something going in regulation. Two away in the top of the ninth. He's from Downey. He's looking to pull this one. Very open stance. That one's over for a strike, and it's 0-2 on Ariel Gitron.
But you've got to ask yourself, with Kenny Harrington throwing two fastballs like he has, if he sees that open stance, is that why, or is he going to go with something off speed?
Throws the curve, didn't miss by much. A little bit outside.
Yeah, normally he'll try and throw that low and inside, but he probably respects the strength of Gitron, so he goes outside with it and did a real good job just missing a strikeout.
Ground ball up the middle. He's going to beat it out. Gitron beats it out, a high throw from second. And the National League is still alive here in the top of the ninth. Marty Rodriguez let that one go a little bit high. First baseman not quite able to get up there. Josh Zach coming to the plate for the National League. Winning run is on.
That was a tough play for Marty. You know, he came across his left-hand side, and I think he thought that the ball was going to hit second base. So he hesitated a bit, and when he did, he juggled the ball.
Josh Zach from St. Anthony's. Harrington's throwing heat, but that one's high. Ball one. Josh Zach from St. Anthony's looking to put the National League on top. They've got a runner on. 2-2 count. Two outs. Now it's 2-2. Sorry about that.
I believe the count's 1-1. Yeah, it's 1-1.
There it is. They fixed the scoreboard on me.
Yeah, Harrington's going to go right after him here.
Oh, that one's well hit. Down the line and left. Into foul territory now. That catch is made. And that'll do it for the ninth inning. We move to the bottom of the ninth, all tied up at three. We'll be right back on Continental Cablevision. Star game knotted at three runs apiece. Out on the mound, Pascucci taking his final warm-ups. He came on after beating the first batter he faced to shut things down. And his job is to hold it at three so his team can get another turn at bat. Looks like number nine,
Chris Contreras,
about to step to the plate. Chris Contreras from Bellflower High School looking to break this 3-3 tie. If he can't do it, we'll move to extra innings.
You know, if you're Steve Fullerton and the rest of the coaching staff on the National League side, you really have to be pleased with what Val's done as the way he got out of that last inning and to have him on the mound now. I mean, he's the one guy you want. He was a tri-league MVP, and he was one of the big reasons why Gar did as well as he did this year. So, you know, if you're going to have a guy out there in the late innings, this is the guy.
Contreras squares to bunt. Official word from Buck Taylor is that the game will end in a tie. This is the last chance for Contreras in the American League. The National League cannot win it. The best they can do is tie. What'd we come out here for?
Let's play baseball.
Pascucci looking to tie it. Here's a ground ball to first. Padilla takes it over by himself, and there's one away.
I don't know about you, Wade, but I've got nothing to do tonight. I'm going to play some ball.
That'll bring up Joe Torre. American League's got to get something going here in a hurry. They're down to their last two outs. Pascucci and Torre, mano a mano, bottom of the ninth. The Italian connection. First one's over for a strike. Pascucci headed for the Milwaukee Brewers organization. Torre coming off a 370 season. There's a curve. Strike two.
You know, if Torre is half the ball player that Joe Torre, who played many years in the major leagues, is, Mr. Torre here said he's going to go to Cal State Fullerton next year. He's
fine school, Cal State Fullerton.
Concentrate on his academics, and he's going to attempt to play baseball. And I knew you were going to say that.
That one's high and away. Yes, I am a Titan alum.
And yes, I am a Long Beach State alum. So we've got quite a bit to talk about. Especially this year, Wade, right?
Yeah, well, I didn't follow it too much this year. Of course, 2 years ago, defending national champions and all.
Okay.
Had lots of time that season to watch them. Torre is gunned down on strikes. One out remaining here for the American League. Robert Castro representing the last hope for the American League from La Mirada. 404 hitter on the season. He's got to get something going here. Pascucci's pitch is high.
You know, Pascucci looks like he's just rearing back and pumping the ball and not really concerned about too much. I might lay down a bunt here. You've got Bright, the third baseman, not moving too much, and you've got your pitcher standing straight up after his delivery.
Curveball inside. 2-0 the count.
You've got to try something to get going.
3-3, bottom of the ninth, two outs. We're told the game will end in a tie if an out is recorded. That one's over for a strike, and it's 2-1. Pascucci's pitch, ground ball, second base charging now, throws him out, and that'll do it. Ladies and gentlemen, the game is complete from Kincaid Field, the third annual 605-91 All-Star Game ends in a tie, 3-3, as both teams approach each other for a show of sportsmanship. Listen to this crowd. They appreciate these kids, and I'm sure they're going to be talking to the rules committee next year about adding extra innings, because I know I feel cheated. I wanted to see these guys fight it out. There they are, shaking hands. For Bob Billinger, this is Wade Sherman reminding you that the third annual 605-91 High School All-Star Game has ended in a tie, 3-3. Thank you for watching Continental Cablevision Sports. Good afternoon, everyone.